If you want cheap PC games, Xbox Live codes, and a whole bunch more, then check out G2A. A link is in the description below. Yo guys, what's up? It's X-Wiz. Welcome back to another Call of Duty video, specifically Modern Warfare, because we had something pretty hilarious happen. So the other day, we actually had a new update from the Call of Duty Modern Warfare team. And basically they made it so you had to do two-step verification whenever you made a new account for Call of Duty Warzone. And basically what that means is you need to make an account. After you make the account, you need to actually put in a phone number where you can recover your account to in case it gets hacked or stolen. And a lot of hackers are pissed off because one of the ways that they would continue to hack was their account got banned, big deal. They'll just make another one and play for free because the mode is free. It's part of the reason why we've seen so many hackers, specifically on PC. This is the two-step verification that they're doing on PC. But a lot of these hackers have their little hacks working specifically on a PC. That's where the cluster problem is at. And so with this update that they did, making it where every new person who makes an account for Call of Duty Warzone now has to put a phone number, it's going to dramatically slow down the amount of people who are hacking because now they have to have that two-step verification process. And after they did this, a lot of those hackers who had been banned and were planning on making their new accounts woke up to that news and were pissed off. So on a forum where they talk about hacking and all this stuff, they found a very funny post, a very funny thread that was started about a hacker who was having a very bad day knowing that he could no longer make an account because the account he had with his phone number was now officially banned and it would not make it easier for him to make a new account. And I want to read this with you guys and read through it, and I'll put it on screen here for a few seconds so you guys can see what it looks like and if you want to read it, but I'm just going to go ahead and read through it and I'm not going to have it on screen the full time, so just keep in mind I will be reading it. And as always, if you guys do enjoy the video and if you want to see more content like this, obviously make sure you guys are subscribed and have notifications on so you don't miss a single upload. If you want to support the channel directly, you can do so by checking out my channel memberships or by checking out my sponsors, Scuf Gaming and Control Freak. Both of them I use every single day when I'm playing Call of Duty. You can use code OGXRACE to get a discount on both, or G2A if you guys want some cheap PC games, Xbox Live codes, and more. But with that said, let's go ahead and jump into it. So this was posted again on a forum that's all about hacking. It says, confirmed. You can no longer make random new free accounts on Warzone. You have to have a brand new mobile phone number to link to each account. Blank cheats work, but they will get you banned 100%. He says it's just a you problem and no other customer have the problem. That is a lie. There are many customers having this problem and no help is given. I tried a pastebin tutorial that Blank sent me to try to fix the shadow ban, giving me 200 millisecond ping a second, and it did not work. And now the tutorial to fix is gone. The cheats work, but you'll never be able to play the game again. You'll have to buy a brand new computer if you want to play the game without being shadow banned when you log off. Not worth buying if this is what happens to you. Very, very displeased with Blank's cheat. Now I can never play Warzone again because the account that had my number on it is shadow banned, and you have to have a valid number to play the game. By far, worst service I've bought and big regret of mine. I even let him take control of my computer so he could go through all my settings and make sure everything was set right, which it was. Do not try to cheat, at least with these cheats. I've given the program a whole week. I thought it would be fine since I could just make a bunch of throwaway accounts, but since Activision has made it so you have to set up your account with a valid phone number, one account per phone number, basically makes the game unplayable for me, as the account I had my phone number authorized to was banned because the hacks were detected, even though he consistently told me it is undetected. Please be aware that it's very much detected and known about. If you buy this, you will get banned. I have made over 20 Modern Warfare accounts. Half of the accounts were shadow banned before I was able to play the game. How are you using the hacks having nothing to do with it? If I create a new account, start the cheat, open Call of Duty, and then close the COD, and then close COD, the account is shadow banned and I have to make a new one. It doesn't matter if I even use the cheat or not because the cheats have been detected already. This cheat needs to be taken down, removed, or fixed so that no shadow bans are given out. So, a lot of people, a lot of hackers are pissed right now because essentially they are losing their accounts. They were using a cheat that they thought was undetectable. Turns out it's detectable. They're getting banned and shadow banned whenever they try to make a new account on that computer specifically, I assume they're taking their IP address or something like that, and when they see it playing from that IP address, they shadow ban it, and it, they get shadow banned, and now when they try to make a new account, they're gonna have to use a different phone number, and it's just, it's ruining these guys' day, and I'm so happy for this. The amount of people who are playing on PC and were getting destroyed by people who are hacking or who are having a horrible time and not being able to actually enjoy the game because of the hackers are now going to have less and less and more over time because of this new two-step verification process. So I'm so happy that Infinity Ward did this. They have saved Call of Duty Modern Warfare, Warzone specifically, on PC. So I'm so happy that they did that. But anyways, yeah, guys, I just wanted to make a short video to talk to you guys about this because this was actually pretty big, in my opinion. This makes it so a lot of people who have been playing for free on PC are not experiencing these hackers. Or if you're someone who plays on console, you might have run into some of these guys if you were playing with crossplay, which is why I always disable crossplay on PS4. I feel bad that Xbox is unable to do it, but with PS4, I always disable it. And so now, maybe we'll finally be able to have crossplay on because there's going to be less and less hackers, especially with this new two-step verification process and apparently all the shadow banning that is going on in the background, which is awesome. I am so happy to hear about this, and I think the people who play on PC are probably the happiest to hear about this because they probably have not been playing a lot or playing far less right now because of all of the hackers, which is kind of crazy that you could just download a hack quick, jump on, get banned, make another account, and keep doing it over and over. So hopefully they're able to detect all the other hacks. I'm assuming there's going to be other cheats and stuff that are found that are undetectable for a month or two or whatever, and we're going to have to kind of wait and reset. But it's a step in the right direction, and I think that Infinity Ward and that Activision are taking it in the right steps here. And it makes me kind of wonder about Blackout actually a little bit, because I never remembered seeing that many hackers, if any, in Blackout. And I think the reason for that was that you had to pay to play Blackout, you know? If you have to actually buy the game to play Blackout, and if your account got banned, you would have to, I assume, because I don't hack, but I assume you would have to make a new account and buy a new version of the game to play it. So it's very, very interesting, and we'll definitely have to wait and see what happens with Warzone, whether the number of hackers drops or maybe they're discouraged and they just stop. I don't think they're ever going to stop. Hackers want to hack, and they're going to continue to hack as often as they can. But anyways, thank you guys so much for watching the video. Hopefully you guys found the video informative and helpful and entertaining. If you did, drop a like on the video, guys. It's super appreciated and incredibly helpful. And if you are new to the channel, if you want to see even more videos like these, I'm going to have a lot more Call of Duty Modern Warfare content coming soon. So make sure you guys are subscribed. And also check out yesterday's upload in case you guys missed it. We talked about the update that we had for Modern Warfare and the new bundles. I did kind of like a first impressions type thing for the new operator Iskar. So check out that video if you guys missed it. Link in the description below for more normal video. And I'll see you guys in the next upload. Thank you guys so much for watching. Again, if you're new, make sure you subscribe, have notifications on, set it to all notifications. If you want to support the channel directly, you can do so by checking out my channel memberships, or you can do so by checking out my sponsors, Control Freak and Scuf Gaming. I use these guys literally every single day, so make sure you check them out. Code OGXRays gets you a discount on that. And then if you guys want to buy some cheap PC games, Xbox Live codes, and more, then check out G2A. A link is in the description below. Follow me on Twitter at OGXRays if you guys want to talk about anything or see what I'm up to. Shout out to my most recent follower here on screen. Anyways, I will see you guys in the next upload. Take care. I'm out. Peace. Good. Location secured.